How do you know when to play which hero? A question that I do see on a fairly regular basis, and it is a justified one. With 26 heroes currently available, picking the right one for any given situation is not the easiest thing, particularly when you lack experience or understanding for the game's mechanics. My usual response refers to exactly that, gaining said experience to better understand when to play which hero, following your gut feeling or listening to suggestions your teammates make. That is usually the best way to learn what does and doesn't work. Making mistakes is part of the process, because knowing why something does and doesn't work helps you understand more to a greater extent. But today, I want to get a little more in depth when it comes to how you can approach picking the right character. And to make it easier for myself, we will be focusing on one bracket of heroes in particular, the supports. Now, I am sure that some of you expect a clear-cut guide that you can follow. When X, pick Y. But for any of you who watched any amount of guide and tip videos I made, you'll know that this is not gonna happen. Overwatch expects you to be flexible, so rather than trying to give you a rulebook that you're supposed to follow, I want to teach you some basic principles that help you making these decisions yourself. That's how you become a good player, not following a guideline, but rather learning why and how to make certain decisions. And of course, we are going to approach this whole subject with solo queue in mind, since it is the most popular way of playing the game competitively. Furthermore, I will try to treat this whole thing as though Mercy is not as prevalent as she is right now. You would be right in your assumption that, at the time of making this video, winning a match without Mercy is a bit more difficult than you'd like. But since I don't want this video to be obsolete a few months down the road, I'm gonna pretend that every support hero is equally viable. So where do we best start? Naturally, the most basic idea that you are supposed to follow as a support player. Now here's something to test yourself with. Is it A, maximizing your healing output, B, staying alive, or C, getting your ultimate as fast as possible? Made your answer? Well, if you said D, this is a trick question, then you would be right. As a support player, always keep this one thing in mind: maximize your value. Naturally, that incorporates all the things I mentioned above, but that's like saying, just play the game and don't be bad at it, and that's not exactly what I'm referring to. No matter which support hero you play, completely discard the idea of trading, and instead focus on your value alone. You're not gonna help anyone if you're constantly dying, but hiding all the time because you're overly cautious is not gonna get the healing out that you need. Not to mention that not every support hero is about healing. We also got utility-based supports like Lucio and Zenyatta. And with Moira blurring the line between main and off support, the decision of which hero to play becomes even more difficult. Naturally, there are certain factors that affect your choice. Which map are we playing? If the map is fairly open, then maybe Moira is not the best idea because there aren't a lot of walls to bounce your orb off of, diminishing your value essentially. But also, your team's composition. If you're going full on dive, then maybe Lucio is a better choice over Ana, because you can accelerate a teamfight by providing speed boosts and hunting down key targets of the opposition. Taking all these things into consideration is fairly important, because you want to be an asset to your team rather than a liability. This is where the experience thing kicks in again, just playing the game and naturally learning what doesn't work by making mistakes that you didn't know were mistakes beforehand. But also being realistic enough to assess these things as such rather than blaming it on your team. But there are also situations where, well, your team is plain and simply wrong. It's a typical you think you do, but you don't situation. For example, Zenyatta is a great hero to play in a massive variety of compositions because his Discord orb is an extremely valuable asset to your team, and Transcendence is a very powerful defensive ultimate. Not to mention that it adds aggressive potential to your team because Zen can dish out a ton of damage himself. But you, as the clever support main that you are, understand that Zenyatta's trade-off is his lack of any sort of mobility. That means that if you play against a high mobility composition and your team refuses to peel for you, then you're not getting any of the value that you want as Zenyatta. Your team thinks that they want and need a Discord orb, but if you're always the first one to get picked off because both teams dive simultaneously, then there's just not a heck of a lot that you can do. According to anything that you learned, Zenyatta would be the right choice, but the situational disadvantage does not allow you to play to the advantages of your hero, and that, my friends, is when you're supposed to be swapping. Lucio might not provide the same level of damage output, but the mobility that he provides not only for himself but for the rest of the team can make up for that if your team's target priority quality is not absolutely garbage. And those are the cases where having you as a support shot call is also a very good idea. Simple enough so far, isn't it? The trick is honestly just understanding why what you're doing is not working. The issue might be your positioning, it might also be a lack of coordination sides of your team as a whole. Whatever it is, if you can't immediately fix it by either adapting your gameplay or convincing your team to change their playstyle, then swapping as soon as possible to play for ultimates is what you are supposed to be doing. As a support, you're usually not out to counter one specific hero in the enemy composition. You're looking to maximize your value by staying alive. Your team might want to go for an aggressive composition and playstyle, but ask for a Mercy. Mercy, however, can only do so much when their team is all up in the enemy's face, giving her no escape path when opposing flankers. So maybe Moira is the better choice. Your team is playing aggressively and divey anyway, something that Moira can support really well. You got bulk healing, mobility, and great damage potential. You don't immediately fall victim to the enemy flankers, and you're supporting the playstyle that your team wants to go for in the first place. So here are the questions that you should ask yourself before picking a support hero, and that in this exact order. Which map are we playing? What kind of composition are we playing? Can I do my job sufficiently in relation to the pressure that the opposition is putting on me? And which hero provides the best value for this current scenario combining map, team comp, and enemy comp? The first two are based on what you see before the game starts, and the last two are important throughout the match. It's where you are required to be adaptive. Sometimes it's all about countering that Nanoblade with a Transcendence. Other times you're looking for a Snowball type playstyle with lots of mobility. And other times again, all you want is that one teamfight every so often that you win thanks to Valkyrie. Now I am sure that some of you are rather disappointed with the conclusion. It isn't as simple as to say, when X, pick Y, but it is as simple as to say, play whatever and learn why it does or doesn't work. If you are one that likes studying, then you can sit down and take a close look at what every support hero can do really well and put that in relation to the map design. Some maps are great for Lucio to get environmentals, others are great for Moira to bounce her orbs around, and others again are perfect for Ana because of the long sightlines. If you then also understand the difference between high mobility dive compositions and stationary death ball compositions, then choosing the right support is going to become an easy task. The question, however, is if you rely entirely on this theoretical knowledge or if you can adapt to the challenges in front of you, which I hope I helped you doing with this video. But this is me done for the day, so I talk about how you can choose the right support hero for the right job. Thank you everybody so much for watching. Don't forget to drop me a like on your way out if you enjoyed the video, subscribe if you want to see more, and I hope to see you all next time.